Great to see all of you here tonight. I see a lot of familiar faces, which is great. I see some unfamiliar faces, which is even better. We're very happy to have everybody here tonight. This year marks the 15th anniversary of the drama ministry here at Family of God. This is the 16th production that they've done. And it's been great. There's been big productions, small productions. We draw people in from the community. We bring new music directors in, new orchestra pit people in. It's a wonderful experience. Tonight's performance has two acts, and there will be an intermission where there will be concessions available in our cornerstone room, which is just straight out the hall and kind of veer to the right. Follow the crowds or just follow the scent of cookies or whatever might be over there. Some quick theater logistics. The restrooms are also straight out the sanctuary, kind of veer to the right. Then there's a hallway down to the right, and they'll be on the right-hand side if you need those. It is a theater. Please silence your cell phones to prevent distractions to the actors and potential embarrassment to yourself. There is no flash photography allowed or recording in this show. The other thing is you can see this theater space is a sanctuary, so there's no backstage or side stage or a curtain or all those fancy things. So the actors and the set crew will be going up and down all four of these aisles very frequently. So if you do have to get up, please be very careful and look out for traffic coming your way. Family of God, we consider these performances as a gift to our congregation and to our community and the surrounding communities, and we are very happy to draw people in, and they're presented free of charge. However, as would well notice by the sets and the people and everybody involved, there are costs to putting on these shows, so we will take a free will donation from you. There's a basket, collection baskets in the back by the ushers. There's also QR codes on the back page of your bulletin. There's three different ways to donate to Family of God. The cost of your donation will be first offsetting the cost of this production, and then after that, the benefits and the proceeds will be benefiting Brooklyn Avenues for Homeless Youth, which is a homeless youth shelter and transitional housing here in Brooklyn Park that the church has been supporting in the drama ministry specifically for the past several years. If you'd like to write a check, you can write out to Family of God. We take all denominations and coins and bills and big bills, just no rubles, no rubles. It worked really good last night. It's not so good tonight. So I'm glad you're all here. I welcome everybody. Please sit back, relax, and enjoy Family of God's production of Little Women.
Sincerely, Putnam.
22.
22?
22 rejections since I've been in New York. And they all say the same thing. Go home. Give up.
Yeah, Putnam is an idiot, and his words are stupid.
F. Putnam is one of the most powerful publishers in New York.
You mustn't lose faith, Miss March. There will be someone out there who will like your stories. I'm certain of it.
Professor Bear, would it be possible if I could read my story to you? I would so respect your opinion.
Yes, of course.
Actually, it's one of my best. It was a mean and stormy night. The moors were bleak and bloody. Thunderclaps! Lightning strikes! The fair Clarissa, her clothes in disarray, races across the wild coastal heath. Now she stops.
Better.
let anything defeat us. Years from now, people will talk about us. One Christmas Eve, four penniless and ragged sisters put on an operatic tragedy for all conquered. Filled with blood and guts, two massacres, a masterpiece, and several heart-wrenching scenes. When Clarissa starts to plead, Christmas will exceed our fears. Tunnels then. But what about Mr. Lawrence?
What about him?
Mr. Lawrence?
Yes, Mr. Lawrence. You.
Me?
You shut down my Crooked Douglas fur. I should have you arrested.
I'll make it up to you, sir.
With what?
I'll plant 6 more.
12.
And I'll chop your firewood for a few days.
Weeks. And I hope such an incident never happens again. Ruined my day.
He loves his trees. Hi, I'm Theodore Lawrence III, but everyone calls me Lori. I've come to live here. Here in Concord. I play the piccolo. I can sleep standing up. And I won a medal at school for holding my breath for nearly 3 minutes before passing out. I thought it was terrifically daring of you chopping down Grandfather's tree like that. Well, goodbye.
Theodore Lawrence III, would you mind delivering this tree to the Hummels?
Sure. I don't mind at all.
He doesn't mind?
Just point me in the direction.
Maybe like half a mile down the road. The red house with the broken shingles.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, Merry Christmas! Joe, you must think before you act on everything. I just want us all to have a wonderful Christmas, Marmee. Oh, a letter's come from Father! Christopher Columbus! I'll read the letter, Marmee.
My dear wife, the war goes on and on, the end seems nowhere in sight. The days are difficult and long, but I am well.
He is well!
Still, it is very lonely away from my dear ones, especially lonely as Christmas is approaching. Each night in my tent, I think of my precious girls.
He thinks of us.
Give them all my love and give them a sweet kiss. Tell them to be good girls, faithful and hardworking, and to conquer that which is disagreeable in them, so that when I return, I'll be fonder and prouder than ever of my little women. Well, why the glum faces? Do we have an operatic tragedy to perform or not?
We do.
Well, then there's work to be done. There are costumes to make and all the old card for you to paint.
And will you perform something, Mommy?
Oh, do you, Mommy?
I'll write something thrilling for you, full of passion. Dare.
Yes, yes, I will. This will be the best Christmas ever. We'll show them that the March women are invincible. Now come on, let's get to work.
I'll
get
my pants.
I'll design a handbill.
I'll look for a costume for Marmee. I still don't know why we couldn't have kept the tree.
Thank you.
don't need saving.
There are many pitfalls a girl can fall into, and Josephine, you are heading toward all of them.
I just want to see you shine. Even if you're not rich, you can at least marry well.
I'll never marry.
You'll marry all the girls married.
I'm not all girls.
Then there is no point in our having this conversation. It is clear to me I could never take you to Europe.
Take me to Europe?
Ah, it was an idle thought of mine.
Do you know how important it is for a writer to travel? It's been my dream, Aunt March.
We earn our dreams in this world, Josephine. Oh, it's foolish of me to think you could ever change your ways.
I could try.
Oh, go abroad and do amazing things. I shall return poised and elegant, brimming with confidence. I shall sit.
Excuse me.
You.
Me.
What are you doing here?
Passed out. Too much dancing, I guess.
Too much punch, I'd say.
Lori! Where is that? Look! There you are. I've been looking everywhere for you.
Mr. Brooke, I want
your grandfather will be furious. He wants you to meet some very important people. Now, Mr.
Brooke, I have. These are the Marsh sisters I've been telling you about. The ones from across the way. This is Meg, right?
Yes.
And this is Jo. She cuts our firewood on occasion. This is Mr. John Brooke. He's a scholar from Boston.
Yes, I'm Lori's tutor. Now, come, Lori.
Oh, sir, wait, you've taken my fan.
Your fan? Oh, yes, I'm sorry, this must be yours.
I have
So you're Margaret March?
Yes.
It's a splendid party, isn't it?
Oh, yes, it is. It's quite lovely. So you're from Boston?
Actually, Maine.
I've never been to Maine.
Well, you should go. It's a beautiful country, quite primitive.
I like it, primitive.
Really?
Mr. Brooke is a romantic.
I do read Sheets and Kelly. I mean, it's Keats and Shelley. It's
So do I.
You read Keats and Shelley?
All the time.
Christopher Columbus.
Miss Meg, would you like to dance?
Meg, we were just about to go join the ladies.
I'm delighted, Mr. Brooke.
Oh, excuse us, Joe.
Tonight.
Fetching.
Really?
So when you're not attending balls, what do you do?
I write blood and guts stories. I make extraordinary plans. I'm going to Europe. I'm going to meet famous writers and revolutionaries. What about you? What do you do? Marmy says you're all alone in the world. No mother or father? That must be awful for you.
It's not awful. I've got a cranky old grandfather, and I've got a cat, and I've got...
What?
Well, I was hoping to say you.
Me? You don't have me.
I know I have the right, but sometimes late at night I watch you at it, pacing back and forth like a maniac. I've never met a girl like you. Anyone at all like me. This is very nice. Such a lovely party. The music sounds so thrilling. It makes a person feel like dancing. I'm very good. I won a medal for dancing at school.
I don't dance. Besides, I've got a patch on the back of my dress.
A patch? Let me see.
No!
I like it! That patch is in a whole new fashion. And I guarantee by next spring, every girl in Concord will be wearing a patch on her dress. You could do 100 things, do anything you please. We could fly on golden wings across the seven seas. I'll bet we get a camel through a needle if you'll take a chance on me.
Are never lonely. All I know is my songs are so intense.
to a skating race. Tomorrow, at the pond. Come on!
Amy? Make sure the fire's out.
Thank you. She is not just a child. She's a demon in a child's body.
If I could bring your story back, I would. My writing is everything to me. Marnie, it is who I am. It's my future. It's my passion. That passion is still in you. Believe me, Joe, it's still there.
I'll never forgive her.
You're not wrong, Joe, to feel anger. But if you build a wall between you and Amy, the one person you may end up hurting is yourself. And I couldn't bear that. Try and get some sleep.
Are you going to play or not?
by the bridge the ice came away. I got here just in time.
She's careless. She's rash.
She just wanted to be with you. Here.
I was skating so beautifully. You don't think. You know you're not supposed to skate by the bridge. Everyone knows the ice by the bridge is dangerous. But you didn't want me skating near you. I love your stories, Joe. I tried to write one to make up for what I did, but I couldn't think of anything to write. So I drew that picture of you with the beautiful hair.
And my big mouth.
You just ignored it.
You skate recklessly. If it hadn't been for Lori, you could have been killed.
Maybe it would have been better if I had.
You must never talk like that. When the ice broke underneath you, all I could think was I could have lost you.
Then go on, Joe. Forgive her.
See how much she's changed.
See if her speaks tight. Everyone stop it. I was devastated when you burned my story. I couldn't understand how you could do such a thing. Promise me. Promise me you'll never think of me as an enemy. But a sister who loves you.
I promise, Joe.
The four March sisters forever.
Forever!
Forever!
Lori. Lori, who saved Amy, made this day possible. I want to declare before everyone,
before the world,
that on this day, that you, Theodore Lawrence III, who has valiantly lost all
gonna be a few more minutes. I'm waiting for Joe to come back. Tell me I'm doing the right thing.
You are doing the right thing.
I've never been away from the girls before.
Your husband has a moment. It needs you with him in Washington.
It's like I'm being torn in two. A part of me here and another part.
I look in on the girls every day.
Thank you, Mr. Lawrence.
Oh, let's take these two to carry. Good morning, Beth.
Good morning, sir. I fixed you this basket of food.
Thank you.
Amy's almost ready. She's packing up half the house.
What is keeping Joe? She should have been back by now.
I'll go look for her. Here's the shawl Father loves so much. $25.17. I threw in a few spare coins I had stashed away.
You shouldn't have done this. I'm so
disappointed.
Proud. It was a very courageous thing to do. Thank you, Joe.
The carriage is ready, Mrs. March. Joe! You look different.
Mrs. March, we must work with a lady to the train.
By summer, I guarantee every girl in Concord.
Let me hug my girls.
We've never been parted before. I feel awful.
Amy, look after everything, Margaret. Don't worry.
My dear Margaret. Oh.
I will, Aunt Marge. Thank you for taking Amy. Amy, tell Aunt Marge how excited you are to be staying with her.
I'm so excited to be living with you while Marmy's in Washington.
No glum faces. No tears. I will be back as soon as possible. How did my girls grow up so fast? Goodbye, Aunt March.
And you'll tell Father how much I love and miss him.
Josephine, what have you done?
Oh, I sold my hair so Marvin could have a safe trip to Washington.
You did what? Oh, I told you, if you need money, to go to me.
I was hoping to make my own money.
Oh, but one's hair and selling it like a beggar is not an option for a lady. You look like a shorn sheep.
Oh, have you forgotten our contract?
I never forget it. Traveling, seeing Europe, Paris, London.
You don't live up to your part of the bargain. Why should I live up to mine?
I tried to live up to my part of the bargain. I went to a ball. I improved my manners. I read books on etiquette. I practiced dancing with Meg. I held my tongue in several situations when I wanted to cry out. I've got a fire in me, Aunt March.
Well, let's see how far this fire takes you in life. Let's see what doors this fire will open. Let's see what society thinks of your fire.
To hell with society,
Josephine!
We don't live for society. We live to expand our minds. We live to fulfill our dreams. Engage in passionate
particularly handsome?
Very handsome, John.
Really? You think so? I'm not the wisest man.
Very wise.
Thank you.
What about our promise to remain together?
We made that a long time ago, Joe. I've changed. You've changed.
I haven't changed. I never make a promise one day and then break it another. Our word is everything, Meg.
I love him.
So you love him?
know you will. You can do anything. You can make the clouds disappear.
It's you who makes the clouds disappear.
Come, walk with me and tell me all about your adventures today.
Well, I sold my hair.
Joe's your best friend, Theodore Lawrence III. Her fingers clutched with rage as she went out into the wretched night.
Lori, Christopher Columbus, it is so good to see you. You haven't been here in weeks.
I was in Boston, and I have dreadful news.
What news?
Well, if the war ended, my grandfather has insisted I get on with my life. He's enrolled me in school.
What?
I'm going off just in time for the summer session.
Well, that's wonderful news.
What's wonderful about it? Leaving the best friend I've ever had.
I can't imagine life in Concord without you. Not seeing your silly grin every day.
I don't want to go.
Well, you've got to go. This is an incredible opportunity. College. I'd go in a minute. I'd study everything.
What made you after schools? You're going to be a famous writer.
Famous.
Joe, I need to tell you something.
Tell me something.
Ever since the first day I met you, do you remember that day?
Of course.
The day you chopped down grandfather's cherished tree. I knew then that you and Ivan would be magnificent together.
We are magnificent together.
My sweet Joe. For weeks now, months even, this whole year actually, I've wanted to...
What was that?
It was a kiss.
I know it was a kiss.
It was my first kiss. I've thought about it for quite a while. We could live a million dreams, but only if we dare. We could go to such extremes. There's so much we could share. I bought you this ring.
A ring? What are you talking about?
I want to marry you.
Have you gone mad? Stop this. It's not funny.
I've practiced saying the words over and over again. Marry me. Marry me.
Have you gone mad?
I love you, Joe. I want you to be my wife.
No. No. Find someone else. Find some accomplished girl.
I don't want an accomplished girl. I want you.
You can't have me.
At least say you'll think about it.
There's nothing to think about. I'll never marry.
You don't mean that.
I do mean it.
You'll marry.
I won't.
You will. Just not me. That's what you're really saying, isn't it? You'll find someone.
Go away. I thought you understood me.
You knew all along how I felt. Everybody knew.
You knew all along who I am. What I want. I bare my soul to you, Lori.
sort of kinship. We have simply gone places together.
The theater?
Yes, I took her to see Hamlet.
Oh, a pathetic tale it is.
Very pathetic. And I've given her 3 German lessons.
3? That many?
And I've taken her to walks in the park to hear lectures. But Miss March hardly seems to know I exist. She rushes past me like the wind.
Christopher Columbus! Mrs. Kirk, have you seen the professor?
Behind you,
Guten Tag!
Guten Tag, Miss March. The word is Tag. Guten Tag means good day.
I know what it means. But when you taught it to me, you said Guten Tag.
I would never say Tag.
Well, I'm sure you did.
Well, I'm sure I didn't.
All right. Guten Tag. It is a very Guten Tag. A wonderful Guten Tag, Professor. And I have amazing news. I came to New York on a dream. I knew it might take me a while. But all I've been hearing since I arrived is leave it right there on the pile. So today I woke up and decided it was time. Time to achieve, time to throw.
Thank you.
against your enemies, you can now return to the moors. Your fate is in your hands.
Chloris raced from the forest. She raced to the moors where she called. I am a dead person. I will free the moors with your fury. Fight me!
I always knew you'd come back to me. They always do.
Chloris thrusts.
Right, Professor.
About what?
About everything. I'm going to be a published writer. $15 and 25 more for my commission.
You are rich.
I feel rich. Do you dance, Professor?
No.
Neither do I. But today I could. Da 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 da.
We should celebrate your success, Miss March. Have you ever been to the Broadway Gardens?
Are you asking me to dinner, Professor?
No. Yes.
I should like that.
More good news, I suspect.
Open it, Miss March.
I will. Today, I could start a revolution. I could...
What is it, Miss March?
It is not good news?
Dear God, no. My sister Beth has contracted scarlet fever.
Oh,
she's gravely ill. I must go to her immediately.
Oh, I'm sorry, dear. Sorry for you and your family.
Is there anything we can do?
No. Thank you, Professor. Mrs. Kirk, tell your girls.
Oh, they'll be fine.
Tell them to keep reading.
I will.
Thank you both for everything.
Miss March, I would like to accompany you.
Accompany me?
You shouldn't travel alone.
I traveled here alone. I'm not afraid. I shall be fine, but thank you.
Miss March, you will be back?
Yes, of course.
And Miss March, feel good luck.
Yes, I need some good luck.
If you say, come with me off to Massachusetts, then to Massachusetts we will go.
We will buy dishes there, maybe even 2 cents.
Buy the wine is China, then we'll dine and buy the drinks and sets.
New York, Miss
in the park to hear speakers shout
how they would change the world.
I too would like to change the world.
Yes, of course. But how are you, sir? Yes, how I am. So how am I? My days are the usual days. I wake up like no.
come true. Come, sit with me and help me put the kite together. Tell me again about New York.
It is a circus.
Circus? Waltzing camels, dancing horses. Sometimes you see them right out in the street. And museums and theaters back everywhere.
And the woman, are they shameless?
Some of them, anyway.
It's an amazing place, Beth. I'm going to take you there.
To New York?
And we'll dine in the finest restaurants and see Shakespeare and ride the omnibus and mingle with unsavory characters.
Sure, I have something for you. That girl over there gave me this shell. I think it might be over 1,000 years old. I believe that once upon a time it had an amazing life. If you put it to your ear, it talks to you.
What does it say?
It says we grow up too fast.
You're a woman of the world now, Joe. So proud of you.
You were first born, not an hour old. I told Marmy,
it's not.
wrench the reins from him.
Yes, ma'am.
Joe, Marmy,
and Amy, remember?
That's almost everything.
Lori? I hadn't realized you were coming home too.
Yes. We all sailed on the same ship.
You look different.
Do I? I'm taller, an inch or so.
It was so good of you to comfort Amy and Aunt March after our loss of Beth.
I was devastated. I didn't come to see you in New York. I wanted to. I thought of it.
I don't blame you, Lori. It was horrible to you. So unfeeling.
You said what you felt?
No, I... Guess what? I sold the story.
I knew you would. I always had this sort of faith in you, Joe.
I know you did.
You look different too, you know. Very distinguished.
Really?
You know, I've learned something about myself.
What's that?
I was never meant to fly on golden wings.
Who is?
You. You, Joe, you were meant to soar. Me, I was meant for more mundane things. I've decided to go into my grandfather's business. I know it's the last thing I would have thought of myself in the world, but the truth is, I'm sort of fascinated with the prospects. I shall be wily and shrewd.
Lori! There you are!
Amy! Did you tell Joe?
Tell me what?
The most amazing thing.
Really quite a thing.
You tell her.
No, you tell her.
been up here. I know. The room needs an airing. And a dusting.
I'll get to it.
The attic used to be such a sanctuary for you. Whenever you were sad or disappointed, you'd run up here, bolt the door, and come back hours later, full of life. I haven't seen Bat Joe in a long time. I can't write. I can't do anything, really. You're right. In the past, I could always come up with something. Beth would say, Joe can make the clouds disappear. I want Beth back. I never should have broken the promise. I never should have gone to New York. If I'd have stayed here, everything would have been different.
Stop it. Nobody could have done more for Beth than you did. You could not have changed what happened.
How do you manage? How do you go on day in and day out as if nothing has happened?
You think that's how I go on?
You are strong and wise. How can I be like you? How can I find your strength?
Don't make so much of me, Joe. I never dreamed of the sorrow. I never thought I'd have reason to lament. I hoped I'd never know heartbreak. How I wish I could change the way things went. I wanted nothing but goodness. I wanted reason to prevail, not this bare emptiness. I wanted taste of plenty, but I refused to feel tragic. Got to be a
never thought I would do it.
Wonder how you were doing.
I bought a kite.
You bought a kite?
Soon after you left, I bought a kite and took it to the park. I never had a kite before. No, you were right to think I was old. I was old.
No, I was.
Everything is different. Everyone knows. My students here, they say, Professor Beck, you are smiling.
meant that, but... yeah, one, two, four.
What did he say?
He said it was a bit long. He missed the blood and guts. He likes the four sisters, particularly the outspoken one. He wants to publish it.
He said that?
If it's all right with you.
Joe, we were... Not today, or next week, but someday.
Welcome, Professor. Come meet our family.
Years from now, people will talk about us. One Christmas Eve, four penniless and ragged sisters put on an operatic tragedy for all of Concord.
Oh, no.
Filled with blood and guts, two massacres, a masked ball, and several heart-wrenching scenes. We'll dim the lights, the crowd will hush. We'll start the overture and Beth will surely blush. And when Clarissa starts to plead, Christmas will exceed our finest dreams.
Joe, do I die again in this one?
Yes. Maggie will die like none before. The world will shudder when your body hits the floor. For when Rodrigo makes you bleed, Christmas will exceed our finest dreams. Now Amy as Clarissa, only passion is permissible. This tragedy depends upon the fire in your eyes. And Beth, when you're the mother, you'll be noble, you'll be pure. All hearts will melt the moment mother cries. Let us begin. Aha!
dear mother, do not cry.
No, 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 Amy. Expression from the heart. Mother, oh, no, dear mother, do not cry.
Mother, oh, no, dear. Joel, I am teased and ridiculed at school, and all that concerns you is your silly little tragedy.
I know you're tired. I know it's hard. But we will triumph when Rodrigo yells on God. Our success is guaranteed. Christmas will be thrilling. Christmas will be gory. Christmas will exceed our finest dreams. I made an important decision today. As you all know, I've been writing stories forever with much satisfaction, and people seem to like what I write.
We love it, Joe.
Absolutely. So I've decided. I'm going to become a world-renowned writer. I shall write great books and earn barrels of money, and I will give you all everything that you have ever dreamed of.
Oh, Joe can do anything.
But we must promise to remain just as we are, solid, like a fortress. No matter whatever happens, we must promise that it'll always be the Four March Sisters forever.
Forever!
Come, let's rehearse.
Mother, oh, not my daughter yet, but I have to cry.
There will be Christmas.